They're definitely getting comfortable.
Happy Frugal Friday, friends. Welcome to the new house. My back feels like I'm 190 years old and I am like bruised up. It's been quite an experience. And today I wanted to share the things that I did not expect when buying a house. And if you're looking into buying a house and you have no experience, I wanted to just kind of share these things in case it helps you. So maybe you won't be so shocked like me, and maybe it will help you think a couple things through before you start your adventure of buying a house. The first thing I didn't expect when buying a house was how flipping expensive it actually is. You guys are, you know, starting to know me. Some of you are new. Some of you have been here since I started. You know kind of how I think, and I just am confident I'm gonna get a great deal, right? Like, that's what I do. In Southern Maine, no, you're not. It blew my mind, the prices on houses. Now, just so you know, before I was actively searching for a house, I was pre-actively searching on realtor.com and Zillow and everywhere, right? I was completely immersed in it for maybe even like, I don't know, maybe even a year, maybe more. I mean, I feel like that was like part of my daily routine. Do you guys do that? If you're looking for a house, or even if you're not, maybe you're just into real estate, you just go to the houses in your area and see what they're going for and what is available. So I kind of knew what I was dealing with, but when it's actually go time and you're really trying to narrow it down to find that house, the prices, I mean, in my mind, were astronomical. I reached out to a few friends like Deidre from Slay This Debt. Hey babes, good morning. Hi honey. As I was saying, Deidre said a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, I think it was somewhere in the ballpark of 175 to 195. That doesn't even exist around here, you guys. Like a 2-bedroom, 1-bath, ranch style, like the most basic is around like, in like the most basic, maybe 230,000. It's ridiculous. So I don't know, what's an average 3-bedroom, 2-bath in your neighborhood? I'm just curious. That was kind of like what I was originally looking for, 3-bedroom, 2-bath, but I was happy with 2-bedroom, 2-bath also. You guys know how important the 2-toilet situation was for us going forward. So that might prompt you to ask, well, why didn't you look in a different area if this is so expensive? The truth is, you guys, consistency for Caden is very important to me, and he loves his school and he's so happy with his school and with everything just that is happening with the virus and everything. Like, we just switched over to, you know, distance learning, and then I don't know what's going to be happening in the fall, but imagine putting him in another school. Like, Kate doesn't play that. I want consistency in his life. He responds very well to consistency. He responds very well to routine. Like, we are in a, this is our happy place. Like, we want to live here. This is where we're happiest, and this is home for us. So it really, like, I did look a little bit in the surrounding areas in like maybe like 3 cities around the area, maybe more, 3. Let's be real. I looked at every city in the surrounding area, like, in thinking like, oh, if we found the perfect home, like maybe I could justify going elsewhere. Didn't find anything, and I'm so glad I didn't do it. The second thing is how competitive the real estate market is. Maybe that's just, again, in my area. I'm not sure. I don't know if it's a Maine thing. I don't know where you guys are and what the real estate market is like, but it is competitive. Firstly, there is very little inventory. So I would be looking at realtor.com like 20 times a day. Refresh, refresh. Anything new happening? What can I look at? And there was very little inventory. It also could be because of the times right now. I'm not sure, but there was not much to look at. The second thing is, because there was such low inventory, when there was a house that was even remotely decent, people swarmed. I remember going to look at one house in a decent neighborhood. The house was decent and it was an open house, and this was right before Corona hit. And it was like just so many people, just I can't even tell you, a very average home and lots of people there, cars just lining the street to see this one house that was needed a ton of work. That's what we were dealing with here. So super low inventory. And as soon as something came on, everyone was there. There were several times that me and my realtor, we didn't even get to go to the showing we had scheduled because it was gone before the appointment even happened. And I was on it, you guys. I'm like, as soon as I saw that house, call the realtor, set an appointment. And sometimes it was gone before our appointment. That is how competitive it was. I hope it's not like that for you, but that's how it was here. So this is worst case scenario. The third thing I didn't expect when buying a house for the first time is how important your realtor is. Take your time to find that person. If you don't feel like you can trust that person, you don't think they're gonna come through in the clutch, you don't think you can openly talk with this person, make sure you wait until you find that person, because they're gonna be your right-hand person through this whole process, and they're the ones with the experience. So I really leaned on her to give me the best advice in all of these situations. And you're gonna spend a lot of time with them. So make sure it's someone that is gonna get the job done and that you feel confident in. That's very important. Karina, if you're watching this, thank you. You're the best. Number four of things I didn't expect when buying a house for the first time was how many houses you were gonna actually have to walk through. You just don't know until you know, you know? I know now. We went through just about every single house in this area under $300,000 and maybe a couple just over, just to see. And it's a lot. So just be prepared and be patient, because you're not going to know what you like until you're in there. And when you're looking at a house from home buying perspective, like you can go other people's house, like, oh, that's nice or whatever. But when it's going to be your house, it's just a whole different ball game. So you might have to go through a lot of houses, and that's just the way it is. Number five, all the things you need to provide when it's time for that loan. When I applied for my loan, yes, I definitely financed, and I had to provide a lot of documentations, W-2s, tax returns, every single thing that helps them paint the picture of your finances, pay stubs, and so much more. And then when I got approved for the loan, it came back with another approved with this even longer list of contingencies that you still have to provide more. So just when you think you're done, there's still more. So I had a checklist of like 12 things I still needed to get even after I thought I was done. You're never done, it keeps going. Number six, the patience that you need to exercise during this process is patience you might have never practiced before, because everything is a process. And of course, it's even probably more of a process during a global pandemic, but you have to be patient for everything. You have to be patient to find the right realtor. You have to be patient to look through all the houses. You have to be patient to, when you finally get the paperwork going, all the loan information that I just talked about. You have to be patient on setting up an inspection. You have to be patient on all the paperwork getting processed. The closing date. Oh, good Lord, the closing date. You have to be patient, 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 and you have to expect things to take a little bit of time. In truth, this actually didn't take a lot of time at all. I looked at this house on May 15th, and we closed on June 23rd. So that's actually not bad at all, right? But while it's happening, especially because of all the work you've done before and the months and months of looking at houses, and then you're like at the end, you're like, come on, like, let's get there. You just want to get in the house. And it's like, you have to just remember every single thing about it takes a little bit of paperwork and then the results of it. And then this happens and then the results of it. You have to be more patient than you've ever been patient in your life. They say patience is a virtue. It's true. Number 7, I didn't expect as a single mother how hard this was going to be making decisions all along the way. Now, even if you're not a single parent or a single person, when you are buying a house, there's very important decisions to be made. But me, the added responsibility of making sure that this all aligns with what would be best for my son. And it's there's no one, you can bounce the ideas off of other people, but they don't have to live with the results. You know what I mean? When you're buying your house, all the decisions you're making are on you. I can ask my realtor, I can ask my parents, I can ask my friends, but in the end, it's all on me. So I didn't expect the pressure and the responsibility to be so palpable. It's been many, many months of, you know, making sure that I'm making the right decision. Because if you purchase a house and you can't afford it down the road, no one's here to bail me out, people. It's me. There's no one to lean back on. There's no one to lean on. There's no one to help. It's me. So this was just such a huge decision. And I spent so much time thinking and obsessing and running numbers. I told you about my faux budget. I can't even tell you how much time I spent on that to make sure that this was going to be a house that I could afford and make sure that this was the right decision for me and for Caden. So the decision making when you are doing this and it's just you, I mean, I can ask Caden what he thinks, but he's 6 and that's not fair to put any responsibility on him for making these decisions. He can share his opinion, of course, but it's us that have to deal with the consequences of my decisions. So just know it's hard. It was hard. It was really hard. I've gotten some really great questions. There's one in particular that I got emailed about my more about the finances of the house and some questions from another wonderful single mama. So I plan to answer that on the Questions with Kate show this coming Monday, if all goes according to plan. That is the plan. So I hope you guys join me again on Monday. And then kind of as things unfold, I want to give you some more tips on moving or budgeting for moving, all that kind of stuff. Let me know the other things you want to know, because while it's all fresh in my brain, I just want to give it all to you. Just want to give it to you. So I hope that this was helpful. I hope if anyone's looking for a house right now, that this kind of stuff helps you think about all the things that you might not be thinking about, because I think it feels like when you're looking for a house all shiny and wonderful and I'm going to be a homeowner and rah, 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 it's way harder than it looks. And I just want to be realistic and like give you these things that I didn't really expect. So I hope this is helpful for you. If you've ever bought a home before, can you please do us a favor and go in the comments now and leave us something that you didn't expect that you learned when you purchased your house for the first time? I think that would be helpful for all of us. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the thumbs up, hit subscribe so you can join the family, and hit the bell so you're notified each time I upload. Currently, I'm making videos every Monday and every Friday. If you miss my live of my home tour, I will leave that somewhere around here so you can check out the new house. Thank you for joining me. See you next time. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Caden says bye. Wait, come here. Let me see your face.
Bye.
The cats are loving this window, by the way. Hey, babies.